Hey people, this is the second part of my Trader Joe's haul. Honestly, because I freaking talk way too much, but some of you guys appreciate it. So this is for the 1%. You are the 1%. Okay. Okay. Then I got this buttermilk pancake mix. You know what? Honestly, people, I didn't realize how inexpensive this is. It's $1.99. And you know how many times, like, I make pancakes? Honestly, every time I cook, like, 99.99999% of the time is only for me. So when I make a batch of pancakes, like, I make enough to, like, eat again, like, the next day. Sometimes I eat them again for lunch. So, yeah, so you know how many meals this is for $1.99? That's amazing. I just thought that was worth sharing. P.S. The pancakes they make are bomb. They're like so fluffy and thick and just so amazing. I just love these freaking pancakes. Okay. Oh, and then I just got this sunscreen because I honestly ran out of sunscreen. And girl, you know, I'm not trying to look age faster than I am, which I feel like I'm aging fast already. So I don't need the sun to help me age faster. You feel me? So yeah. And this is just face and body sunscreen. SPF, water resistant, UVA, broad spectrum, UVB, all that great stuff. And I feel like it smells good. Otherwise, I can't really smell it. But the section I was in at Trader Joe's, everything smells really good. So I think that's part of the reason why I bought it. But I feel like it was a mixture of all the other product scents and not really just this, but I just still bought it. Because look how cute the colors are. Sunshine! Okay. And then I got my vanilla coffee in the Andy Warhol packaging. Yeah, I'm still on my vanilla coffee craze. I just can't bring myself to buy normal coffee. I just can't. It just has to be vanilla coffee. And with like vanilla creamer or like sweet cream creamer, it's just like, bae, the perfect cup of coffee. You feel me? Okay. Oh, what is this? Oh, look at this. Ooh, fancy. So fancy. This is sparkling French berry lemonade. And people, they have tons of these kind of sparkling lemonades at Trader Joe's. And they are all in this awesome, cute bottle, and they're all like different colors because of the different like fruit lemonades they are. And I don't know if I ever bought this exact flavor, but I bought these kinds of lemonades in the past, like very rarely, because like, it's like a sugary drink, you feel me? And I love sugar, and I eat sugar all the time. Probably way too much. So in any way that I can, I try to like cut down the amount of sugar I drink or consume or whatever. And so I just always, and plus it's like something fancy, you know, you don't need it to survive. But lately I've just been feeling like I should just like do little things to, you know, just make myself feel more fancy, you feel me? So this is a little, you know, just a little thing. You know, it's not like I'm gonna drink this in place of water. I'm still gonna drink water, but you know, put it in a nice glass and, you know, have some nice relaxing time. I think that's a good idea. Yeah, so. So cute, huh? Okay. Oh my gosh, I have so much stuff. Okay. We're almost done. Then I just got this, it's upside down. This Turkish honey, and they have like different kinds of honey at Trader Joe's, but this one is produced by bees foraging nectar from primarily rock rose, citrus wildflowers, and Turkish pines Doesn't that just sound so like, ooh, bougie, doesn't it? Or is it just me? And then I like the bottle it comes in. It's so, it reminds me of like Art Deco, right? It's just like in a honey thing. I don't know. And then I've tried it before, and I feel like there is a slight difference in the taste. That could just be my mind, but I like it. You know what the thing that's crazy about it? On honey, it always says do not feed honey to infants under 1 year of age. That's scary. That is so scary. Like, why? Will it kill them? I don't know. That's scary, right? I don't care. I'm still gonna eat it. Okay, I put it in my chamomile tea. And I also sometimes like if fruit is like too tart, I like put it on my fruit. So I've done that with like peaches that are too tart. What else? My blood oranges, they're like too bitter for me, so I put them on my blood oranges. So it's just a nice, natural sweetener, you know? Okay. Oh my God. Oh, I thought I was gonna knock something over. Oh, we're done. The last thing. Okay, the last thing is this canola oil. And I use this to just, cook things. Because honestly, people, I read this article on BuzzFeed, honestly. So obsessed with BuzzFeed. I read this article on BuzzFeed about it said, I think it was like facts about olive oil that you never knew, or ways you've been eating olive oil wrong or using olive oil wrongly. And it said on there, I mean, people, a lot of things on the internet, you kind of have to take with like a grain of salt because it could, you don't know who's writing it for what purpose. There's a lot of conflicting information out there. So you just kind of have to decide for yourself what you want to believe because, there's crazy stuff on the internet. But anyways, one of the things it said was that olive oil is meant to be like consumed, just like poured out in like with bread or like, it's not supposed to be cooked with. And that kind of blew my mind. And the reason why it says it shouldn't be cooked with is because once it reaches a certain heat temperature, which I don't really remember what the temperature was, but I feel like it was like a low temperature. Once it reaches that temperature, it can become like carcinogenic, whatever that word is, carcinogenic, whatever that word is that makes food like basically poison for you or like toxic. So I was like, what? Whoa! Because like anytime I've cooked for the past, like, I don't know, since I was 14 years old when I started cooking for myself, like, I've always used olive oil. And like I know like so many other things in this world that I consume that I expose myself to do have, small levels of carcinogens or, are toxic to me. But if there's like a way, like certain of those things, for example, bacon, I'll take my chances with, I'll do it every once in a while. But like olive oil, I feel like just replace it with the oil that doesn't, If I can like replace it, do something differently, and it's not gonna affect, my enjoyment of food, why not do it? So it said one of the oils you can use to cook with is canola oil. So that's what I've been using making the switch. So that could have just started a whole war for some people. But I mean, that's that. And I disable comments on certain videos that I know will get certain people mad. So, because I just don't like to deal with that hateful comments. But, anyways, that is everything that I bought at Trader Joe's. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Peace. Thanks for watching.